So in this case we will see, so what mean by types of force vibration presented by Professor Deshmukh MS. So we will see the force vibrations. So what exactly the force vibrations are? Force vibrations quite easy here, that the when we are applying some external forces over the system, that is called as what? The vibration, that called as force vibration. In this case we have to see the types. So some of the formulations we are having, the taking into account mx double dot is equal to mg minus k l plus u minus u zeta u dash plus f of t. So by taking into account mg is equal to kl, we are called as the degree of equation of the force motions. Now the case number one, that is periodic external force. So in this case, that is the external force we are applying, and we are having f of t is a period function, such as f of t is equal to f of 0 sin omega t, f of t is equal to f 0 cos omega t. Then by the method of undetermined coefficient, the particular solution of the force motions can be obtained as. So we got some equations, and we are having some characteristic equation, that is m r square zeta r plus k is equal to 0. We are considering some conditions and we are get something roots, just like r comma 2 that is equal to minus zeta plus minus under root of zeta square minus 4mk divided by twice m. Then by taking plus and minus, we are get the two roots. Now the solution of the corresponding homogeneous equation is u of t is equal to e raised to lambda t c1 cos omega t plus c2 cos sin mu t. Okay, so we got the some general equations in terms of the u of t is equal to up t plus un t. Okay, now come to the our first one, that is types of the force vibration, that is first, that is a force damped vibration, steady state and transient solutions. We are got some motion of damping, zeta is less than not is equal to 0. Okay, which is less than 0 or more than 0. So it implies the following condition: zeta is positive, under that condition lambda is equal to minus zeta upon twice m less than 0. Zeta that r1 comma 2, that is roots, having not equal to omega, the under that condition s is equal to 0. So the general equations of this case, that is a mu t u t upon is equal to r cos omega t minus lambda minus plus r1 e raised to lambda t cos mu t minus lambda. So first indicate the steady state condition, second indicate the transient solutions. So emphasize the transient solutions dies as the time decreases, lambda is less than 0. Okay, so we are taking the limit t tends to infinity u c t is equal to 0. So by considering all these equations, we got the case number one. Okay, case number one, that is the lambda is equal to 0 minus g omega t. Now the general solution of this, that is u of t is equal to r of t cos omega t minus lambda plus r1 cos omega 0 t minus lambda. So this is a pure, that unbounded, as the time increases, we got the pure resonance conditions. Okay, case number two, that omega is not equal to 0, omega 0, that is s is equal to 0. So this is the case. Now again u of t is equal to minus twice f and minus twice f 0 divided by m omega 0 square minus omega 0 square sin omega in bracket omega minus omega 0 by 2 into 2 bracket complete sin omega plus omega 0 divided by 2 into t. This is slowly varying sinusoidal amplitude. So this is the case. Now this is the types of motion processing. A period variations of the amplitude is called amplitude modulations effect, AM. Amplitude modulation means what? AM. Now this is a zigzag line showing that constant amplitude means what? Free vibrations. The uniform vibrations carries sin omega plus omega 0 by 2 into t. सिग्नल्स आर माइनस ट्वाइस एफ जीरो अपन एम ओमेगा जीरो स्क्वायर माइनस ओमेगा साइन ओमेगा माइनस ओमेगा जीरो टी. सो दिस इज द वेव्स अगेन. Now second waveform showing the something difference variations in the amplitude because of the damping will change. Okay, so this is the case where we have seen something that force vibrations and that of your the types of vibrations we can say that is damp, underdamp and overdamp. These are the conditions and we have seen some fluctuation in the load. Now again the amplitude of modulated waves u of t is equal to twice of minus twice f0 upon m upon f omega 0 square minus omega square sine in bracket omega minus omega 0 divided by 2 into t whole bracket into sine omega plus omega 0 upon t. Now the what is the basic difference in this case again? In this case we are having something that something constant instead of a free we are having the uniformity in the equations in the waves. There is constant application of force while in the second something degradations and the above of the case. So these are the ways where we are taking into account the variation in the types of vibrations, that is especially for the post vibrations. So again quite easier to understand all the concepts.